What's up, everybody, and welcome back to CrankBabies.xgg, where today I'm bringing you another video on Riders Republic, and today's video is all about shortcuts on downhill mountain bike racing. And I'm just going to get straight into this because this might be a little long. I'm going to show three. I would like to say, if you guys know any other events that have shortcuts in them, please leave that down in the comments. You know, we're all about helping each other on this channel. I'd love to know them. I mean, I probably do know them, but I could only get three in this video because, you know, these are long races. So let's go anyway and check out the first one. I think I'm going to do what I think is the easiest one first. And this is over here. Of course, as always, we start at Rider's Ridge. And we're going to come straight over here. And it's this one. Let me see if I can actually get on it. And it's the Santa Cruz Urban Ride. This is a downhill race. And the reason why this one's a little bit hard, you can see that third objective is the extreme finish in under a minute and 43 seconds. It's worth 10 stars. I know a lot of people have a little bit of difficulty doing this one, but if you know the shortcut at the beginning, this is actually a really easy race. I'll catch you guys over there. Okay, so this is, of course, the Santa Cruz Urban Ride. And I'm not really sure if you can do this in time if you don't do the shortcut at the beginning here. I don't know. I've never tried. But it's just coming off here. We're going to go down past these people. Come out here. Super easy. Let's get back on the boost so we have our speed back up. And that's pretty much it. That is the shortcut. If you know the rest of this trek, you should know that it's not that difficult of a trek. We're going to just see if we can finish it and get under that minute and 43. I should. Done it quite a few times. And I will apologize again. My voice is not quite back yet. I just can't seem to get rid of this cough. And it's really killing my throat. And that's making my voice really quite bad and just croaky. So yeah, anyway. Like I said, this race isn't the hardest anyway, and you can see I've just messed up there, and I still am pretty confident I'll do it in under 143. I think because this is all on roads, there's not really a lot of need to brake or slide around corners on these. You can just kind of take your finger off the acceleration, and that should be enough. And I guess any other tip on this, I kind of always save my boosts for when I'm going uphill. Or anytime I'm on jumps, when you come into that landing, you just want to hit the boost a little bit more. And yeah, just keep yourself up above 90. And there we go. I think I did it. I actually didn't see it, but I'm pretty sure I did it. I think I got 139. If I'm correct, did I do it? Yes, there you go. And that's pretty much that race. I hope that helped you out, and we're going to go on to the next one. Okay, so let's go straight into the next one. And this next one is, of course, we're going to do Arrow Run. I think, personally, this has got to be the hardest downhill race in the game. I mean, for me, anyway, I think it is. Even knowing the shortcuts, you're not guaranteed that you're even going to come first. That's how hard this one is. And, of course, this has two runs on it. So you got to do it perfect both times. Now, there is a couple different ways that we can do this. I think there's three different ways that you can do the shortcut at the beginning. If you want to know the hardest one to get the quickest time, type Arrow Run into YouTube and just check out the very first video. I can't remember who made that video, but it says something like a world record next to it. I don't know if it's a world record or not, but the course he takes at the beginning is extremely difficult. So I'm going to show you guys the second way that I do, and it's a little bit easier. I'll catch you guys over there. Okay, so this is, of course, Arrow Run. Now, this has to be the hardest event in the game, I think. And it makes it even more difficult because there's two runs. This is your first shortcut. We're just going to jump over that fence. And then, of course, we're going to head over here and get down onto this. Saving our boost for this section here so we can get through the snow as fast as possible. And then, yeah, of course, this is still an absolutely difficult race. And it's because there's two runs. You have to do it perfect both times. And honestly, even if you do it perfect, you're not going to beat the AI by that much. This has got to be the funnest turn in all of Riders Republic. That is a crazy blind turn right there. I love it. It's huge. Of course, we keep on the boost as much as we possibly can. Now we're coming up to our second shortcut. It's down the bottom here. We're going to take a right. I slowed down way too much. And we're going to come off these rocks and jump down here. Hopefully miss that out. Well, we didn't miss it, but it's good enough. And there we go. We have beaten the AI. And as you can see, I've taken two shortcuts, and I'm still only 2 seconds away from second place. And this is why, I mean, I don't know, every other event in this, the AI isn't really that great. I guess it's maybe because we're not racing against them. I mean, I don't know what they did with these times, but that is difficult. And I can't imagine the AI actually took those shortcuts. But man, yeah, this is again why I said this is the absolutely most difficult downhill race. And especially to get that third objective on the elite finish. Okay, for this second one, I'm going to show you the slightly easier way. If you don't want to make that jump there, we just still hang a right there, and we're going to come down here. It brings us out to the same exact place, except for when you see this tree, we're just going to come down here and go this way. Saving your boost again for this snowy section because it's absolutely horrible to go through. And I'm not going to do the whole race again because you've seen the rest of it. But yeah, if you want to just copy what I did there, it is a slightly easier way to get through this race. Okay, for the third and final race I'm going to take us to today, this is probably one of my favorites in the game, and it's just straight up from Rider's Ridge. We're going to come here, and this is, of course, the Fox Racing Mountain Rush. I really like this event. There's not a huge, I guess, shortcut that we're going to take, but there's a couple little sections that hopefully my advice will help you out with. I'll catch you guys over there. Okay, so this is, of course, the Fox Mountain Rush. Now, there's no real shortcut to this one, but I am going to show you, I guess, the routes that I take that, you know, saves you some time. Now, first off, we stay up high here and then move down low. But then the second bit here, we're going to stay up high again. And it's just favorable terrain. Little half jump to get over that snow. It's just around this next turn. We're going to cut some corners. You're going to see this little flag and aim for the flag. It brings you out perfect onto that. And we're going to just shave that one as well. Try and just power through this as much as we can. Now this one, very hard turn. Use the snow. It helps a lot, so you don't want to come off the track at all there. We're just going to burst down this and see how fast we can get. And we want to save a little bit of boost here. And I'll show you why. We're just going to take off that turn there and jump over that rock. And the reason why I say save your boost is for this section here, because we're going to boost straight through this. Using full boost, trying to get down through this, and of course save a little bit to get back up this hill. And this brings us into the worst section of the course. It is absolutely disgusting. I'm just going to say it straight out. I hate this section. It's so hard. Every turn is kind of blind, and every turn has a little kick to it. And it makes you want to jump going into the turns. And you gotta just not do them. Now these 180 bends, again, just slide through them. Save your boost to get out of them. And that's the best advice I can say for that. Now we're coming up to the final section where we're gonna be hitting a lot of 180 bends. Now that turn, oh my god, I can't believe, I knew it was coming, and I still didn't break for it. Okay, let's see if we can still do this. Now, we're going to be hitting these 180 bends. We're coming down the mountain. We're coming up to the finish. We got to slide around these. Don't slide on the inside or you're going to be kicked up. You don't want to leave the ground at all for these. And make sure you have enough boost. On every turn, we can just boost out coming into the next turn. And hopefully we've done this here. I'm hoping. And we did by 1 second. Man, even with the little cutting corners, I should say, in this, I've only done it by 1 second. Now, that was definitely not the best display I've ever put on doing that race. But hey, I got it done. Now, the advice is still sound. If you take the route that I've taken and cut the little corners that I've shown you on that, that is how you do it. It's just unlike I did. You're going to have to stay on track a little bit more. I hit a lot of snow there. And yeah, that one turn coming into the final section, you've just got to know it's there. And honestly, don't slam into the boards. It's just really difficult. It might take a bunch of times trying this one out. But once you know all the turns, it's not too bad. And hopefully this helped you out a little bit. Okay, guys, that's going to be it from me today. I really hope this helped you out. Like I said, that last one on the mountain rush, there's really no shortcut there. So I wasn't quite sure if I should put it into this video. But I would like to ask again, if you do know any other events in this game that are downhill, maybe a skiing one or just anything that has some shortcuts, let me know down in the comments. I'd like to go check those out if I don't know them. And of course, if I do, I might make a video on those too, just to help you guys out a little bit more. Anyway, I'm CrankBabies.xgg, and I'll catch you guys next time. Don't kill my speakers with the sound.